Our memory is not a recording machine or a hard disk. When we learn, we don't throw boxes of information into our memory. Instead, we link new information based on what we already know. We sort of translate new information. We give it meaning based on existing knowledge. You can imagine your memory as a road network with cities. Each city is a bit of information in your memory. When you learn something new, it's like building a new city and connecting it with existing cities, that is, with existing information. The more roads you build, the better this new city is attached to your network. If a road breaks, you can always reach the city or remember something via another route. Building roads is the process of encoding new information. During this process, you synthesize, you make analogies, you find examples, use your imagination, and you explore new material from different angles. For example, let's say that you learn the vocabulary of a foreign language and you want to memorize a new word. Building roads here means that you ask yourself questions. Do you know any familiar words that are similar to this new one? Any words with the same origin? Any synonyms? Any antonyms? You may want to form a couple of examples, or you can just close your eyes and visualize yourself using these new words in a real-life scenario. All this is the encoding part of learning. Obviously, this process requires time and effort, but it's necessary if you want to remember something for the long run. If you don't put enough effort into this process, you risk forgetting what you learned sooner or later. Have you realized what I've done right now to explain encoding to you? I've made an analogy with a road network. I've also used an example taken from language learning. But I didn't do this particularly for you. I did it first myself to understand this concept and install it into my head. So, to recap, when you learn something new, make associations, find examples, use your imagination, look at the material from different angles, prove it or disprove it. Don't skip this process. It's not a waste of time. It's an investment towards your learning and remembering. So, to learn effectively, encode it!
Hey guys, thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked it, don't forget to press the like button. If you don't want to miss more videos like this, press the big red subscribe button. I've also written a book on how to learn more effectively, based on research in cognitive psychology. If you want to check it out, click on the picture of the book. I'll see you in the next video.